is a very big black hole. This is the horrible bit. Stepping back over that edge. It is truly one of the forgotten wonders of the world. Woo! Majlis al Jinn is a masterpiece, and its geology is mind-blowing. So I'm walking on limestone that was formed on the seabed tens of millions of years ago. Tectonic plate activity lifted that up until we're now well over 1,000 meters above sea level. And millions of years ago, the movement of water carved out this huge cave. Most of that water's now gone, but where I'm standing now is damp. The ground's actually sodden. You can see it's darker than everywhere else here. After heavy rains, this would be a temporary lake, and there are streams that run into it from the side. But for now, that water goes down through the porous ground and off into different cave systems. It's likely that these mountains are peppered with caves that are just as big and spectacular as this, but in all likelihood, no human being will ever see them. The only chance would be if something like this happens, if parts of the ceiling collapse, so you get these skylights that give us a gateway to the underworld. And here, well, eventually that whole ceiling will come down, and then this will turn into a sinkhole. Eventually after that, it'll erode into a valley and all this wonder will disappear. The story of water here in the Middle East is a powerful one. Because the surface is so arid and dry, water doesn't last very long up there, it evaporates. So places like this are the only reservoirs, aquifers, for water. And as that dries up with the increase in population, it is entirely possible that the next significant conflict in the Middle East won't be over oil, it'll be over water.